Welcome to UT Southwestern's What to Know. A study involving 45,000 North Texans was launched earlier this week to help us better understand who is getting COVID-19 and how to stop it from spreading. Joining me today to discuss the study are two experts from our Department of Population and Data Sciences at UT Southwestern, who are helping to lead the study along with our partners at Texas Health Resources, Dr. Amit Singal and Dr. Jasmin Tiro. Thank you both for joining us. So Dr. Singal, you're the principal investigator for the DFW COVID-19 Prevalence Study. Tell us what a prevalence study is and why it's important to our community.
So the numbers that we see on a regular basis truly represent people that have been hospitalized with COVID-19 or have severe symptoms that require testing. But this likely only represents the tip of the iceberg, and there are many more who have likely been infected with COVID-19 that go unrecognized. We know that many people are actually asymptomatic, and the CDC believes that this may represent 40% of all cases. There are also people who have minimal symptoms and therefore don't have access to testing or don't get testing. And therefore, prevalence studies actually go out and they assess what the active infection rate is and the exposure rate in larger populations.
So how will people be selected for this study?
We actually want to have a random sample of people throughout Dallas and Tarrant County. And to do this, we're actually going to select people by addresses and mail them an invitation to actually get the testing completed.
So Dr. Tiro, when someone is selected for the study and receives the invitation in the mail, what should they do? And why is it important for them to be in the study?
One of the most important things about this study is making sure people check their mail. And that's something that a lot of people report that they don't do regularly. And so we really need them to answer the call to participate so that we have a strong response rate. And our findings, as Dr. Singal mentioned, are representative of the breadth and the diversity of our DFW area. When they answer the call, what they will be doing is going online or making a phone call back and answering a survey. This survey is short, about 10 minutes. And after that point, they'll be scheduling an appointment at a testing site that's convenient to them. We've worked hard to distribute our testing sites all over the Dallas and Tarrant County area. And for those who are housebound, we've also created a program so that we can do mobile testing for those individuals. We hope everyone is really interested and eager to participate, because the faster we recruit participants, the faster we can share those findings.
And Dr. Singal, tell us about the tests that the people that are participating in the study will undergo.
We're using two tests as part of the study. We're doing a nasal swab that checks for the PCR, or the active infection. And then we're doing a blood test that actually checks for the antibodies, and that tells prior exposure. And so we think between using the two tests, we'll have a comprehensive assessment of active infection as well as prior exposure since the pandemic started to get a sense of how COVID-19 has impacted our local community.
Tell us why you need such a large number of people to participate in the study and why that's important.
We selected 45,000 people to really get a good sense of, once again, the greater Dallas and Tarrant County areas. And by doing that, we're actually selecting people across different socioeconomic strata and different racial ethnic groups. And so we'll be able to actually tell if there's differences in the risk and the exposure profiles between those different groups. And this will start to give us some idea of why those differences may exist and how we can intervene upon those differences to actually promote health equity.
We're also hearing that people in different industries that have different jobs might be affected differently. Will the study address that?
In addition to 30,000 people that are going to be selected from the community, we're also selecting 14,000 high-risk essential workers to see what the actual exposure is and the risk is in those industries. One of the unique things about our study is that we're focusing on non-medical essential workers. We're going to invite people from industries such as grocery stores, retail stores, and restaurants, to see what the proportion of people who test positive in those different industries.
So Dr. Tiro, these are all going to be really important questions for us to understand where the virus is and how fast it's spreading and what populations are most at risk. How soon will we have some results that we can act on?
Our first release of interim findings will be after recruiting 25% of our sample. And we'll also share process data on how our recruitment is going. We're working with our 30-member community advisory board to think about the best way to lay out our information and visualize the data to make sure that that information is helpful to policymakers and community members.
How can people help us accomplish this study and do this important research?
Well, first, check your mail. And if you get invited, participate. And help us get the word out. Talk about the study with your network of family members, friends, and coworkers, and encourage them to check their mail. We're designed to gather this information within the next 4 to 5 months. But if we get recruitment faster, then we can get the word out and the findings out faster.
So Dr. Singal, tell us a little bit about the information that will be acquired throughout the study and how long you think the study will take to complete.
The main goals that we would want to do is to figure out how much COVID-19 has impacted Dallas and Tarrant counties, which populations are truly the highest risk, and which geographic areas are the highest risk, so we can start to really develop interventions that can really prevent this from getting worse in the future. The data that we'll have here in terms of the different risk factors and the differential exposures, we believe would be generalizable to all different metropolitan areas, and once again, can inform ways to prevent surges like what we're seeing here in Dallas and Tarrant counties elsewhere. One of the other aspects that we're doing is that we're following people over the next year. Once again, we've seen how you can have rapid changes in the prevalence of COVID-19. And so I think this longitudinal component where we follow people will answer several important questions. I think all of us are holding our breath and, you know, holding out hope for a vaccine that, you know, hopefully is around the corner. But these data about the length of immunity can even be important in a post-vaccine world where we would have to know how often these vaccines would need to be repeated.
So Dr. Tiro, tell us a little bit about how this study could serve as the foundation for other important scientific work as we understand COVID-19 better.
We've really carefully reviewed and incorporated current knowledge about COVID into our study design. And also, we've built a strong research infrastructure. It's that strong infrastructure which makes me really excited about being a part of this research study and how it's going to be of benefit to both Dallas and Tarrant County.
Well, I want to thank you both for joining us and for leading this important work. Thank you again for watching, and stay safe and stay healthy.